My name is Thomas Kelly. I was in a college group effort to find lost media around my area, as some have been found here in the past. Our group found multiple things: a preschool movie about shapes and colors being friends, a commercial for a never-launched restaurant chain, and lastly a VHS tape that disturbed us all. We will be going in depth for all of these. The first tape was titled, Color and Shapes, Friendship. It looked to be a 1998 3D animated film made to capitalize on Toy Story. It featured four splashes of paint with thin legs and arms. Red, an arrogant but friendly beneath the surface guy; green, a laid-back man; yellow, the protagonist, bright and overly friendly; and blue, a sad and pessimistic color. They meet the robot-like shapes, square, triangle, circle, and octagon. The shapes need color, and in return the shapes would defeat the cursed color, who cursed all the colors to be erased. The movie had low quality, the animation was rather poor, it occasionally had behind-the-scenes footsteps, and conversations. The characters at some point would try to confront the cursed color, but when the camera is about to pan to this cursed color, it just gets stuck and keeps repeating the last 16 frames before it was about to pan over, which goes on for 15 minutes until the tape ends. We found it in a crate in our local warehouse. The crate was labeled, For Destruction. The second tape was titled, Fisher's Seafood. It started with the robotic mascot, Fred Fisherman, waving at the camera, saying,
Hello wonderful people, I am Fred Fisher, and welcome to my seafood shack. Here we sell fish, salad, drinks, and so much more. You can play with friends in our playing area. We can't wait to see you here.
The camera panned around the layout of the restaurant, but after a while, a faint figure can be seen entering a door, which glitches out the camera to high hell. The camera starts displaying a maintenance video on a scrapped mascot, Sebastian C. Baron, as they are polishing the metal on the torso when they open up the chest. The chest is censored with a black square, but I could guess it was something disturbing as it freaks out the employees, one of them throwing up and another attempting to call a phone before the camera gets knocked to the ground and cuts off. The tape ends there. This one was found under the tile of a Jack in the Box restaurant. The last tape was the most disturbing. It made us quit our expeditions for quite a long while, with one of us permanently leaving. It was dated 1959. It starts in a still position facing a padded room, in color. There was somebody inside, a shaved man presumably in his 50s. He has cuts all over his back and while his legs aren't visible, he does walk strange. He keeps spitting out nonsense. A male scientist says,
Begin the first test.
And somebody walks in with a taser, weapons, and a syringe full of a dark green substance. The subject stands still and gets the first injection, which makes his nose start bleeding. His eyes start fidgeting rapidly and he starts shaking until he falls down on the ground. After about a minute it all stops and he gets back up. The camera goes black and mute for a second before cutting to the subject again, who is chained to the wall. A technologically advanced for the time metal hat is strapped on him with wires attached to the ceiling. Then an electric pulse travels through the wire and into the hat. The subject shakes violently and his eyes are highlights with a red oily substance, definitely not blood. The camera begins cutting out again. When it returns, there are red cracks in the wall behind him. It starts breaking down, with a red glow consuming the man as the camera falls down and there is audible alarms. The camera returns one more time. There is another scientist yelling in pain before a brutal noise shuts him up and spills blood in frame. The camera is picked up and faced towards the subject, who is now disgustingly twisted. He had no skin and charred flesh, eyes and nose missing, head hollow. His rib cage was exposed out the front and his spine exposed out the back. As he picks up the camera, a taser hits him in the head and forces him down, followed by gunshots and the camera cutting blank. It was found in the basement of an unknown structure. These are three examples are my reasons why most lost media needs to remain lost. Please stop looking for it, you might just find something you were never supposed to see. Sincerely, Thomas Kelly and his team.